Hi, I'm Michael Carrere, and this is Psych Exam Review. This is a practice question video, and we're going to look at 10 practice multiple choice questions related to psychological disorders. And before we get to the questions, a few quick reminders on how to use these effectively. One is always try to come up with your own answer first. So I'll pause after I read the question and before I show the multiple choice answers. And you want to use this time to try to think of some answers on your own. And you might want to pause the video if you need more time to do that. And then you can use the multiple choice answers, and hopefully you have a sense of what you're looking for. And make sure that you also review any other unfamiliar terms that appear in the question, in the incorrect answer choices, or in the explanation. So let's begin. This researcher sent pseudo-patients to gain admittance to institutions with a phony symptom. Aaron Beck, David Rosenhan, Thomas Saz, Robert Hare, K. Redfield Jameson. And this would be B, David Rosenhan. In a controversial study, Rosenhan sent pseudo-patients claiming to hear a voice saying thud or empty to institutions, with nearly all of them being admitted with a diagnosis of schizophrenia. During a manic episode, Charles described his diet, business plans, political aspirations, and several new hobbies in only a few minutes. This is referred to as word salad, mixed states, aphasia, alogia, flight of ideas. And this would be E, flight of ideas. Flight of ideas is a common symptom of a manic episode, in which the sufferer is very talkative and rapidly changes topics, making conversation difficult to follow. High impulsivity and instability of relationships and self-image is characteristic of antisocial personality disorder, borderline personality disorder, schizotypal personality disorder, histrionic personality disorder, psychopathy. And this would be B, borderline personality disorder. Borderline personality disorder falls under cluster B for dramatic, emotional, or erratic personalities. And it involves potentially self-damaging, impulsive behaviors and relationships that rapidly shift from idealizing to devaluing others. Susan hasn't left her apartment for several weeks and fears something terrible will happen if she does. This is most characteristic of specific phobia, generalized anxiety disorder, agoraphobia, separation anxiety, adjustment disorder. And this would be C, agoraphobia. Agoraphobia is characterized by an intense fear of public spaces where escape may be difficult, such as transportation, parking lots, malls, theaters, or crowds, causing the sufferer to actively avoid these environments. Erica is very worried that she has developed a brain tumor, despite negative diagnostic scans and a lack of symptoms. According to the DSM-5, Erica is likely suffering from somatic symptom disorder, hypochondriasis, conversion disorder, illness anxiety disorder, dissociative identity disorder. And this would be D, illness anxiety disorder. Illness anxiety disorder refers to excessive worry or anxiety about an illness in the absence of related somatic symptoms. Which of the following is a negative symptom of schizophrenia? Catatonia, auditory hallucinations, anhedonia, disorganized speech, delusions of persecution. And this would be C, anhedonia. Negative symptoms refer to behaviors common in healthy people but absent in sufferers, while positive symptoms are present in sufferers but absent in healthy people. And anhedonia refers to a decreased ability to experience pleasure and can occur in sufferers of schizophrenia as well as a number of other disorders. This suggests mental illnesses result from a combination of genetic predisposition and environmental factors. The medical model, the axial system, the eclectic approach, the diathesis stress model, the chemical imbalance model. And this would be D, the diathesis stress model. The diathesis stress model is a way of conceptualizing the occurrence of mental illness as a genetic predisposition, or diathesis, combining with environmental experiences, stress, to reach a hypothetical threshold for a particular disorder. Regarding symptoms of depression or anxiety as resulting from nerve weakness, could be an example of avolition, comorbidity, labeling, cultural explanation of distress, stigmatization. And this would be D, a cultural explanation of distress. Shenjing Shuai Rou, or nerve weakness in China, is a way of interpreting the cause of some symptoms in a manner that fits with traditional Chinese medicine, and would be an example of a cultural explanation of distress. Kessler, 2005, estimated that 7 to 12% of men and 20 to 25% of women will suffer from depression at some point, known as the lifetime prevalence, preparedness theory, comorbidity, point prevalence, incidence. And this would be A, the lifetime prevalence. Lifetime prevalence estimates the percentage of the population that will suffer from a disorder at some point over the course of their lives. Point prevalence refers to the percentage suffering over a given time period, often 12 months. And incidence refers to the number of new cases in a given time period. Jane shows a fear of gaining weight and a belief she is fat despite a BMI of 15. She rarely eats and occasionally attempts to vomit following food intake. Jane would likely be diagnosed with binge eating disorder, bulimia nervosa, pica, body dysmorphic disorder, anorexia nervosa. And this would be E, anorexia nervosa. Jane's severely low body mass index, which is a person's weight in kilograms divided by their height in meters squared, would warrant a diagnosis of anorexia nervosa, with her purging suggesting the binge eating purging subtype, though she doesn't engage in binge eating. Okay, so that's the end of these questions. I hope that you did well. I also hope that you found them challenging. Make sure that you review any terms that appeared that were difficult or unfamiliar to you, and share any suggestions or questions that you have in the comments below. Thanks for watching.